Well, thanks to our couples and thanks to you at home. Bob Eubanks, we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
It's the Newlywed Game! And here are today's newlyweds. This couple walked down the aisle 13 months ago, Barbara and Bob Thornton. Our next couple did the I do's 15 months ago, Patty and Joshua Faust. This couple made it official just 1 month ago, Sherry and Tommy Osteen. And our final couple exchanged their vows 3 months ago, Michelle and Christopher Jones. And now, here's the star of the Newlywed Game, Bob Eubanks.
Welcome to the Newlywed Game. Hey, let's say hi to our four couples. How are you today?
Great.
Ready to play the game?
Yes.
Then, ladies, before we get started, why don't we send you off to our soundproof room, all right? If you would, please. And, gentlemen, in round one, we'll be asking you some five-point questions. You'll be answering these questions as you predict your wife will answer the same question when she returns. Now, if her answer matches your prediction, you then get 5 points. And remember, each correct prediction brings you that much closer to that fabulous second honeymoon. So the ladies are gone. And here's your first question. Guys, I want you to take a look at the other husbands on the show. Just take a good look at the other husbands on the show. Now, looking at the other husbands, if we put you all in a go-go boy dance contest, which of the other husbands will your wives pick as the sexiest dancer? Christopher, who do you think she would pick as the sexiest dancer? Do you think it would be number one, number two, or number three? Which one?
Probably number one.
Number one, all right. Wait, Joshua. Josh, what do you think? Would it be number one, number two, or number four?
I'd have
sexiest
to go with number
dancer.
One, Bob.
Number one, okay. Bob?
It's a hard question because...
It's not a hard question.
It is because there's... I'm the one.
Hey,
you
hey,
know?
Hey.
And, but,
which one of the other husbands?
I'm going
the eagle
for number,
maniac?
I'm going for number three.
No, no, no.
She's going for number three.
Pardon me?
She'll say number three.
Oh, I thought you said you're going for number three.
You know, we're married.
Yeah. Tommy, number two, number three, or four?
I'm kind of worried about two, three, and four over there, but I'm going to say my wife would like number four.
Number four, all right. Next question. Gentlemen, will your wife say that total strangers are more surprised that she married you or that you married her? Joshua.
I guess I'd have to say that she married me.
They're more surprised that she married you.
Yeah.
All right. Bob?
She married me.
Tommy?
They're definitely surprised that she married
that
me.
That she married you. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Christopher?
Oh, without a doubt, she married me.
That she married you.
Yeah.
Last of our five-point questions. Gentlemen, what will your wife say is the one thing she does that sometimes makes you think there's a big macho truck driver trapped inside her body? What does she do, Bob?
Tries to kick my ass. You know?
Tommy.
Well, let's just say, she's a weightlifter. She's a weightlifter.
That she lifts weights.
Yeah, she's a
okay.
weightlifter.
Great. Christopher?
Oh, that she burps.
She burps?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
You should hear her.
Maybe we'll have time.
Oh, we will. Okay.
Oh, good. I can hardly wait for that one. Joshua.
I'm going to have to go if she burps.
She burps, too.
Oh,
all right,
yeah.
Gentlemen, thank you.
All
we'll be right back to reunite our newlyweds. We'll see how well our husbands are predicted with their wives this year. We got up for these messages.
Darkness falls upon your streets to possess your eyes with tricks and treats.
If you could only feel what I'm feeling.
Costumed MCs.
Good evening.
And famous names.
I'm Vincent Price.
Fill y'all's TVs and haunt your games. No one can resist the wills to watch these Halloween chills and thrills. Starts October 29th only on Boozer.
Thank you. Welcome back to the Newlywed Game. Gentlemen, we've recorded your predictions on cards. You now have them in front of you. Each time that your prediction matches your wife's answer, you get 5 points. One couple with the most points at the end of the show wins a great second honeymoon. Ladies, nice to have you back. Hey, gentlemen, I want you to do me a favor. Put the cards down to your left. If you would just lay them flat on the floor, if you would, please. Now, would you please come out here in front of each of our podiums? Yeah. Make a line. Just make a line. That's it. Now, spread out a little bit. Spread out a little bit. Now, ladies, here's what's going to happen. We're going to have a little dance contest right now between the husbands. They're going to have 20 seconds to do their sexiest go-go dance. And then afterwards, you and the audience are going to pick the best dancers. I should also let you know that the husband that the audience picks as the sexiest dancer is going to win a new color television set. Hit it, boys. Now, Sherry, other than your husband, who do you think was the sexiest dancer out there?
Other than my husband?
Yes. Number two, number three, or number four?
I'm going to have to go with number four, Bob.
Number four. Yes. He predicted you would say it would be number four. Yay! Yeah. Okay, Barbara, would it be number one, number three, or number four? Sexiest dancer.
Oh. I have to go with number one. I mean, I got a private dance.
Number one. He said you would choose number three. Yeah. Patty, would it be number one, number two, or number four?
Number one.
Number one. Your husband said number one. Yeah. And Michelle, number one, number two, or number three? You
number think it was one.
Number one. Your husband said number one. All right. And I'm just curious, who did the audience say? The audience said the sexiest dancer is number four. So, Christopher, that means that you and your wife win a color television set. Not bad
yes,
at all.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Next question. Ladies, would you say that total strangers are more surprised that you married him or that he married you? Total strangers, Barbara, are they more surprised that you married him or he married you?
Definitely that I married him.
Yeah, I can imagine. Yeah. He predicted you to say definitely that she married him. Yeah, you got it. Patty, yeah, total strangers are more surprised that you married him or he married you?
That I married him.
That you married him. He predicted that that she married him. Yes, you got it. Michelle?
That I married him.
That you married him. He said that she married him. Yeah. Well, Sherry, what do you think about this? Total strangers.
That I married him.
Really? Why?
Yeah, definitely. you just have to know Tommy.
Pardon
me? I don't know. You just have to know him.
I'd have to know him?
His past is a little different than you might expect.
What are you trying to tell me? Okay. Tommy predicted you would say that she married him. Yeah, okay. Next question, ladies. What would you say is the one thing you do that sometimes makes your husband think that there's a big old macho truck driver trapped inside your body? Patty, what do you do?
Belch.
Belch.
Oh my God.
All right, he said that what you do, you burp. Yeah, you got it. Michelle?
I'd have to say the same thing, belch.
Really? He said that you burp. Oh, yeah. Sherry.
I'm gonna have to go out the other end, Bob.
Oh my gosh.
He always.
Yeah, it's okay, yeah, it's okay. Tommy said the one thing you do is that you lift weights. Well, what? Now you admit it to the whole world what you do.
I do. You lift weights. Tommy stinky like every day.
Yeah, well, Okay, Flower. Barbara?
I would have to say that it would have to be burp, too.
You burp also?
Oh, yeah.
Your husband said the one thing you do that makes him think. Card for me, Bob, please. Card for me, Bob, please. Yeah. No. You try to kick his butt. And you have my permission to start right now. Yeah, okay. We'll be back with the wives to see how well they predict what their husbands will say right after these messages. Your husband's excluded off stage. Your turn to predict what they will say. And remember, each of these questions will now be worth 10 points. First one, ladies, which of these foreplay techniques will your husband say is most characteristic of your approach to love? Will he say you're a tickler, a talker, a pincher, or a nibbler? Patty, what are you?
I am a nibbler.
Nibbler.
I'm always nibbling on his ears, on his neck.
Okay, Barbara?
Definitely a nibbler.
You're a nibbler.
Because... yeah, our sex is real oral.
Pardon me? Okay, fine. Sherry?
Nibbler.
You're a nibbler.
The same, yep.
Really?
I mean, I talk a lot about it too, but I follow it up with nibbling.
Oh, really? Okay, Michelle?
Tickler.
You're a tickler.
I'm a tickler.
Okay, next question, ladies. Who will your husband say you think he idolizes just a little bit more than a grown man should? Barbara?
Who does he? Howard Stern.
Howard Stern?
Yeah, he's fixed. Asphyxiated with him. He loves the man. It's his hero. He loves him.
You know
it's
what? I could have really guessed healthy. That. I really could have guessed that.
It's not healthy.
Yeah. Sherry?
I'm going to have to go with Howie Long.
Howie Long.
Yeah. He's addicted to football, watches all the time, just says he's the man.
He's the man. Michelle?
I'd have to say Magic Johnson.
Magic Johnson. Yep. Fine. Patty?
Billy the Kid.
Billy the Kid.
Don't know why. I don't know Billy the Kid, but it's all over. It was all over his room.
William Bonney. Ladies, what will your husband say is the hardest part of his entire body? And what's the softest part? Sherry, what's the hardest part of his body?
Hardest part is definitely his chest.
His chest. And what's the softest part?
I'd probably go with his tummy.
His tummy?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Michelle?
His butt.
His butt's hard? What's
and
the softest?
Tummy.
Tummy. Patty, what's the hardest part?
Oh, my gosh. His stomach.
Stomach is hard. What's soft?
And his buns.
His soft. Buns. Soft buns.
Just flabby a little bit.
Flabby. Okay. Barbara.
The hardest part would be his butt, because he's always walking around talking about what a nice, firm little butt he has.
He needs counseling, you know that?
And the softest part would be his tummy, because he's been
married
for about a year.
25-point bonus question. Ladies, what will your husband say is the last food that you and he shared in bed? Last food that you and he shared in bed, Michelle?
Last food would be homemade cookies.
Cookies. Patty?
Potato chips.
Potato chips. Barbara?
Cereal.
You had cereal in bed?
Yep.
I knew that. Sherry?
I'm going to have to go with frozen yogurt, ice cream. Well, frozen yogurt.
Which one do you want here?
I would like frozen yogurt.
Frozen
Bob.
Yogurt. Okay. Hey, Sherry, you know what? I'll be right back, okay, and get you some. But first, we'll be back with the husbands to compare answers on the New York Day. Right after these messages. Game. All of our couples have scored some points, but now we're going to see how well the wives have predicted what the guys will say. And remember, these questions are now worth 10 points. And here's our first one. Gentlemen, which of these foreplay techniques would you say is most characteristic of your wife's approach to love? Would you say she's a nibbler, a tickler, a talker, or a pincher? Bob?
Tickler.
Tickler, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I knew that. Shooter wasn't in there, by the way. But. She said that she is, she's a nibbler. Yeah. Joshua.
She's definitely a tickler.
She's a tickler.
Oh, yeah.
All right, she said for sure that she is a nibbler. Nope. Thinking? Hey, Christopher, what do you think about this?
Ooh, nibbler.
She's a nibbler. Your wife said she's a tickler.
A tickler? Wait, when do you ever tickle me?
It has.
It was the closest thing.
Nibble.
You mad?
No.
Oh, okay. Tommy?
Pub. She is the biggest pincher there is.
The pincher.
This is the pincher.
The pincher.
If there was
of
ever
time.
A pincher, this is her.
Who?
This is Sherry, my wife.
Oh, your wife. Oh. She predicted that she definitely is a nibbler.
But not when I'm trying to get romantic with you.
This is the pincher.
Well,
the
pincher. I like to pick and stuff. Pinch, I don't pinch. Not when.
Pinch.
Get romantic. You don't sit and reach up and pinch. No. Next question. Let's try this one, guys. Who would you say, gentlemen, you idolize just a little more than a grown man should? Who do you idolize, Joshua?
Shania Twain. She's a woman. I tell you, I mean,
hey,
she's bad.
You're not kidding.
She's bad.
Yeah, she's bad. Yeah. Ask Mutt. All right. No, she said you idolize Billy the Kid just a little bit more than you should.
Oh, yeah. I guess him, too.
Yeah. Christopher.
I would go with Muhammad Ali.
Muhammad Ali. Your wife predicted Magic Johnson.
Oh, you're right.
Yes.
Oh.
Oh, darn. Tommy.
I can't wait for football season to come around. It's got to be Howie Long.
Howie Long.
This guy.
Your wife said it would be Howie Long. Yes. Now, Bob, this is other than yourself. Who do you idolize a little bit more than a grown man should?
There's only one person in the world.
Who's that?
And that's, I would rather be me and die today than anybody else and live forever except
Who?
For Howard Stern.
Howard Stern.
Yeah, Howard Stern.
Wow.
Yeah.
Your wife said, Howard Stern! All right. Next question, gentlemen. What would you say is the hardest part of your entire body, and what's the softest part? Christopher, what's the hardest part of your body, sir?
My abs.
Your abs. And what's the softest part?
My butt.
Your butt, all right. She predicted the hardest part of your body is your butt, but the softest part is your tummy.
Wait a minute. We do abs every day for like all week long,
know,
7 days a week, and my
little...
butt is the softest.
No, your butt's firm.
Tommy, what's the hardest part of your body?
Hardest part is my pecs.
Your what? Do that again.
That's my pecs.
Teach me how to do that.
I can't do it either, Bob.
And what's the softest part?
That's my gut.
Your gut?
My stomach.
All right. She said the hardest part is your chest and your tummy. You got it. Okay. Yeah. Okay, Bob. What's the hardest part?
Well, I'll always be a hard ass. You know what I mean? So, but...
Is that your answer? The hardest part is your butt?
Yeah, the ass.
And what's the softest part?
I'm 32 years old, and it's, you know...
You're how old?
32, and it's catching up.
Man,
yeah,
you're aging fast.
The stomach is the softest, yeah.
Pardon me?
The stomach.
Stomach. So it's your butt the hardest and your stomach?
Yeah.
He didn't say his head, Barbara. I'll be darned. She said the hardest part is your butt, the soft spot is your tummy. You got it right. Okay. Joshua, what's the hardest part?
I guess I'd have to say my abs.
Your abs. What's the softest part?
My butt.
Your butt. She predicted you would say hardest stomach, softest buns. You got it right. Okay. Before we get to our 25-point bonus question, let's see where our winning couple will be going on their second honeymoon. Kramer.
You're going to Hawaii. The DoubleTree Hotel, conveniently located near Waikiki Beach, a luxurious room with balcony for a magnificent view of the tropical island of enchantment. The DoubleTree Alana Waikiki Hotel. Have a wonderful second honeymoon, and back to you, Bob.
All right, Kramer, thank you very much. Time now for our 25-point bonus question. Gentlemen, what is the last food that you and your wife shared in bed? Last food you and your wife shared in bed. Couple number four, Christopher and Michelle. You have 15, 25, we give you 40. Get it right, you'd be in first place. Chris?
Oh, man.
Hurry, please.
Dessert.
What was it, though?
Ice cream.
Ice cream. She said you shared, card for me, please. You shared cookies. Couple number two, Bob and Barbara with 25. 25 gives you 50. Bob, take over the lead with the correct answer.
Ice cream.
Ice cream. She said you shared cereal in bed. Couple number three, Joshua and Patty with 25. 25 would give you 50. Get it right, and you will be in first place.
Pizza.
Pizza. She shared. You shared potato chips. Couple number one, Tommy and Sherry with 30. 25 gives you 55. Tommy, what's your answer?
It's got to be some sort of Mexican food.
What was it? Hurry, please.
Say burrito?
Burritos. No, she said the last thing you shared was frozen yogurt. However, you guys end up with 30 points. You're a grand prize winner. Tommy and Sherry with 50. Couples, and thanks to you, I'm Bob Eubanks, and we will see you next time. Bye-bye.
Super Password! Our special guest this week from Love Boat, Patricia Klaus and Dick Martin! And the star of Super Password, Bert Bandit!
There you are, sir. Thank you. Thank you for that nice welcome. Welcome to Super Password, the end, the finale of our very, very special week, the Tournament of Losers, which is over today. Actually, I should say our first annual Tournament of Losers, but we don't know if it's going to be annual because we don't know if we're going to be annual. We hope we're annual, and we hope we can do it again because I think it's been great fun. I really enjoyed having people back on who deserved another chance and got it. I think that's been great. Do you like it?
Indeed.
I am so
marvelous.
For those of you who have tuned in late and don't know what I'm talking about, we are having contestants on the show who didn't win a dime the first time they were on. Nothing. Zero. Didn't win any money at all, and we've asked them to come back and give them another chance. And it's interesting because what we're going to do now, and we're kind of getting to that point, we've said how loose it's been, no pressure. Well, the pressure is building because we're playing for $5,000 each time on the end game. However, the contestant who has amassed the most money during the week, that person will win an additional $10,000 bonus. So that's what we're playing for. And, okay, shall we meet our players? Come on in, losers. Miriam and Mary Rose. Hi, Mary Rose. Nice to see you again. Miriam, a pleasure. Okay, Mary Rose, tell us about yourself and the last time you were here, too.
Well, the last time I was here, well, we know what happened. I was here with Patsy, Jack, and Gloria Loring.
Aha. Two good players again. Very good players.
What can I say?
Yeah, not too good for you, but no. They were very good players for somebody.
Yes.
And tell us where you're from. Tell us about yourself again, if
my
you
name
will.
Is Mary Rose Colopy. I live in Costa Mesa with my husband, Bill. I used to teach, but now I'm home with my two little ones, Billy and Amanda.
Okay, and you're back here again, and
again.
Welcome to you.
And oh, William. I'm proud to be a loser, too.
Oh, yes, that's right. That's your battle cry.
We're going
T-shirts that say that.
Should have that. Proud to be a loser. Okay, Miriam, please.
My name is Miriam Soswitz, and I'm a flutist. I do mostly recording sessions, but a lot of live performance as well.
I remember you.
And
that
today
very well.
Is my sister's birthday.
It is?
My sister Arna. It's her birthday. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, sis. Okay. We've taken care of all of our business. Did you have something to add?
Down to business. That's
down
all.
To business. The $100 puzzle, so named because it is worth $100. And this is it.
Wow. That's heavy.
That's why I get the mediocre bucks. And if you're ready to go, Dick and Patricia, give me the clues. Here comes the first word.
So.
Off we go. There it is. Everybody has it. Dick, please.
Bones.
Skeleton.
Right.
Yeah, good girl.
Very nice.
Good girl.
Very nice.
I was going to say red. Skeleton.
Oh, wouldn't have worked, probably. All right, we have skeleton on the board. Miriam?
Could it be Halloween?
Could it be Halloween? Off we go. Next word, please. Dick, please.
Roller.
Coaster.
All right. Patricia.
Wheels. Derby.
Dick.
Ice.
Skate.
Right.
Yes, okay. On the board. Skeleton and skate, Miriam.
I don't have a clue.
Oh, you have two clues, actually. But I don't know what it is either. Anybody up here have an idea yet?
I don't have them.
Skeleton skate. Next word, please. Everybody at home is getting the word now. Dick, if you will.
Home.
House.
Right. Yes, excellent.
Good.
Okay. Skeleton, skate, and house. Miriam?
Could it be closet?
Could it be closet?
That's another good one. Not it, but it's a good one.
Next word, please. Gee, I don't know what in the world. All right, Dick.
Key.
Lock.
Right. Yes, excellent. Okay, you're knocking them off. Skeleton, skate, house, lock. Miriam.
I really don't know.
Oh, my. Okay. I think most of us up here know now, don't we? Okay, Miriam, you got this is your last chance up here. Here comes the last word. Dick?
Can...
All right. Patricia?
Bottle... opener.
Yes, that's it.
Oh.
Skeleton, skate, house, lock, and opener, Mary Rose.
Key.
Is it a key? Very nice. You got all the words. Too bad. All right, that's $100 for Mary Rose. We'll come back in just a moment with our final day of Tournament of Losers after this message. Don't go away. You're a winner.
Hamlet or dandruff? Lily Tomlin or chickens?
What are they talking about?
Frogs, they go ribbit, ribbit with frogs.
Talk about. It's a word game, new to Buzzer, that everyone will be talking about.
We're gonna say diamond.
You're right!
Yeah. Now you can talk about, weekdays at 8, right here on Buzzer.
Okay, we're back. It's the $200 puzzle coming up, and the winner of this one gets to play the cash word, but it's $1,000 this week, all week, so it's fair to everybody. If you're ready to go, Mary Rose and Miriam, given the clues, here comes the first word of the $200 puzzle. Show everybody at home what it is. Miriam?
Fissured.
Cut. Okay. Mary Rose?
Nut.
Boats.
You've all seen the same word I'm seeing.
I'm
she said nuts.
Yeah.
And Pat said bolts.
She said. Smashed.
Broken. Fourth and final clue, please.
Mirror.
Cracked.
Yes. Mirror is a very good clue.
I'm so
sorry. Very good. All right. On the board.
Thank you, Patricia.
On the board, we have cracked, Pat.
Of course. Mirror.
Is it a mirror?
No.
Okay. Next word, please. Here we go. Show the folks at home what it is. Last day. Mary Rose?
Mouth.
I'm sorry.
What is that for?
I am.
Illegal?
Sorry.
Okay. Moving on. Too much demonstration.
Mouth.
Lips.
That's mouth. Correct. Okay. We have cracked lips on the board, Dick.
Oh, have we? Is it Blistex?
Is it Blistex? It certainly could be. What's wrong with that? Next word, please. Everybody at home is getting their word. Miriam?
Susan?
Mary Rose.
Susan. Goodness gracious. Susie.
Yes, well, loud, you said it. Susie. Oh, hello. I wouldn't have even guessed that. I would have given it as a clue.
I've been scared to death to get that.
There, yes, me too. Okay, we have cracked lips and Susie on the board. Pat?
Chapstick.
Is it chapstick? That's why you said blistex. Oh, my. To the medicine. Okay. The score, Mary Rose has $300. Miriam has yet to score. The cash box is yours. The cash word, not the cash. What's the cash box? No, it's not a cash box. It's a toaster, and it's a cash word in it. It's worth $1,000 if you will have three clues. Take a look at your word. We'll show everybody home what the cash word is. There it is. And we're ready for clue number one, Pat.
Loom.
Weave.
That's it. First cash word today. You're welcome. Very good. Okay. You're in there now. Okay. With our score, $300 for Mary Rose. And Miriam is yet to score. She will. We will change partners and break away for commercial and wind it up. Going for $5,000 over there and a $10,000 bonus.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. On this Valentine's Day, I hope I have a Valentine for you now, Miriam. You've got to play catch up. You are down. You haven't scored yet. You don't want to walk out of here with nothing. This is the time. Mary Rose, you have $300, and if you're ready, this is the $300 puzzle. Patricia Dick giving the clues. Here comes the first word. We're playing for $5,000 over there in the end game, and as you know, the contestant with the most money at the end of this day gets a $10,000 bonus. All right, Pat, off you go.
Clog. Shoe.
Okay, Dick.
Spark.
Plug.
Yes! Good clue. Very good clue. You went, what? Oh! Okay, we have plug up there, Mary Rose, for the game for you.
I have no idea.
Play okay. Arizona.
When in doubt, when in doubt. That's what Dick always says. Here goes. Next word, please. Show the folks at home what it is. Rolling along, Dick, please.
Donald
Duck.
Right. Yes.
What a girl. Good girl.
You weren't gonna tell you.
You're trying to give us a heart attack. Dick.
We have plug duck. Mary Rose for the game.
Plug duck. Bathtub.
Is it bathtub? Yes! It is so bad. Okay, now congratulations to Mary Rose. You have won the game. We have Miriam here, who came here because she never won money the first time. She has not won any money the second time.
You can come back next time.
Wait a minute. I think we should do something. I don't think Miriam should go out of here empty-handed. Bobby Sherman just threw a bag of candy, which is not enough. I'm sorry. That's a nice try, but I won't accept that. I think we should promise some funds. Don't you think there should be I think we should do something. How about...
Next time we do this...
How about $100? What? I'll do it. For me, you have $100, so you don't go out of here empty-handed. Thank you, Mary. Great to have you with us. Okay. We'll come back. And play. Are we going to come back or are we going to go away? You're waving your hands at me. Oh, hi. We'll come back and play the super password over there for $5,000 after this message. We're going to crown a winner very shortly. No, we can't be twice. That's terrible. Yeah, that's true. But
next, are you super password obsessed? Yes? Great. We'll stay right there because Buzzer's got more super password coming your way. Stay tuned.
Congratulations to Mary Rose. Your first time here, of course. We know that. You know how we play this game. And we were talking about poor Miriam, who didn't win again for the second time. If we have a second annual Losers Tournament, Tournament of Losers, Miriam's going to be our first contestant back. I think it's only fair. But Miriam will get another chance. I think that's only right,
sure,
don't you?
She should do it until she gets it wrong.
I think so. Okay, now, you have 10 words, as you know, Mary Rose. You're definitely in the thick of things, by the way, for the $10,000 bonus, I should tell you. We'll give you letters from C through L, 10 letters, C through L. Everyone you get right, I'll give you $100. If you get them all, of course, I'll give you $5,000 more. You already have $1,600, so you're doing very well. Dick, you know how we do this over here. You have 60 seconds to get them all, and let's take a look at your first word on the board, shall we? There it is. Okay. Good luck to you, Mary Rose. Ready and go.
Cheese.
Cake.
Cheese.
Crackers.
Kind.
Cheddar.
Right. D. Evil.
Devil.
E. Seven.
Eight.
F. Shape.
Figure.
G. Huge.
Gigantic.
Green.
Giant.
H. Alfred. Director.
Hitchcock.
I. Play. First act. First. Oh.
J.
Karate.
Judo.
K.
Mile.
Kilometer.
L.
Crab.
Lobster.
Yes.
Oh, we blew it on. Oh, I blew it on that one.
Too bad.
Yeah.
It happens.
Intermission.
Too bad. You said first act. If you'd have said
first,
pause,
and then act.
And then act. And then I don't know what you'd have said. I guess pause. Or act. Second?
Yeah, just keep
act. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Between.
You had them all, too. You were doing very well. You had 8 seconds left. Well, all right. Here's what you did. You got $900. You now have
$2,500. That's great.
We will come back with the totals and find out the winner of our tournament right after this message.
Thank you.
Now, what's the problem now? $2,500 is better than what you gave here. That's a nice big difference. Oh, too bad.
I was so happy when she got better.
I know, I know. This is the final act of the Tournament of Losers, and I'm standing here with a bunch of winners, as a matter of fact, who've been with us all week long. I've had a great time with them. I hope you've all enjoyed it. Karen, our thanks for being with us. You leave us with a grand total of $1,400, and our thanks for being here.
Thank you very much, but I really enjoyed myself.
I hope you did. It was great to have you with us.
Thanks.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Thank you.
Okay, Tim, you leave us with $1,500. How does it feel to be a winner instead of a loser?
Hey, it's great. I mean, you know, so depressed, and then you come back and win, and it was the greatest experience. We really enjoyed it.
Thank you for being with us. $1,500 for Tim. Here's Mary Rose, who came down to the finish there and had a heartbreaker, as a matter of fact. You were doing very well, but you've done very well. Now,
yeah.
You won nothing last time, right?
Right.
Zero.
I don't want to hear that anymore.
Well, I'm trying to tell you that because it's such great contrast, because you leave us now with how much?
$2,500.
Yeah, not bad. Thank you, Mary Rose. All right, we're getting towards the end here, and the money's getting a little larger, as you can see. Tommy, it's been great having you back with us, truly, and good luck to you.
Thank you.
You won last time, zero. This time, where do you end up? Tell us what you end up with.
$5,600.
That's right, not so bad. $5,600 is...
I forgot.
Doesn't sound like a loser to me. What are you going to spend it on?
I don't know yet.
You haven't thought about what you're going to buy?
Not yet. We'll see.
I want to hear gifts. I want to hear things you're going to spend the money on. Here's a fella. I remember you, Marty. When you think about coming on the show and you haven't won a nickel and you don't feel you're ever going to get another chance to play or win again, this is really kind of a special moment, I would imagine. I can see how you all reacted to it. That's why I want to do this again. I thought it was great fun.
Great.
Here is our grand winner. And it's great to have you back again this time.
Money
won more money than anybody. He leaves us with $15,700. Monty, I'm dying to ask Monty what he's going to do with the money. What do you think?
Oh, pay for school for someone special I know, and let's see. Buy me a few things, pay off a few debts, and buy some roses for a couple of ladies that helped me get on this show. So I think that's what I do.
Well,
I want to say thank you to Ginger and Joyce very much for allowing us all to do this.
Yeah,
it's wonderful.
Me too. Thank you, Ginger and Joyce, our talent coordinators who handled this beautifully. Thank you all, winners, for being with us. You were sensational. And thank you to Dick and to Pat. I'm glad you were here for the special week. I don't know why I'm talking this. I don't need this. I have a microphone already.
And I'm going to cry.
No, don't cry. Don't cry.
It was a good week.
It certainly was. Thank you all for being with us. We'll see you Monday. Goodbye, everybody.
A member of our studio audience will receive a Whirlpool Time Master microwave oven with microcomputer touch control. Program all cooking cycles, times, and power with a touch of your fingertip. Quick defrost cycle and bi-level cooking rack furnished by Whirlpool. And some of our departing contestants will receive Skyway's newest luggage for easier handling on stairs, curbs, and tight places. Luggage on wheels. Outdoor twist fabric and colors, including new coffee brown, furnished by Skyway. A Gordon's Jewelers gift certificate. Redeemable for fine merchandise furnished by Gordon's Jewelers. A Sears catalog gift certificate, a spring catalog with over 1,200 pages of ideas. The most complete catalog in America. There's more for your life at Sears. Rich, creamy Heath ice cream bars with crunchy toffee tidbits mixed right in. That's why you can't beat a Heath. Armor lower salt bacon. Enjoy sliced bacon with 1/3 less salt. Same great taste but lower salt. Another innovative product from Armor. Canfield's Diet Chocolate Flake Soda, bubbly with chocolatey-rich flavor that lets you fill up without filling out, from Canfield's. Because the answer to the first puzzle was inadvertently revealed, the puzzle was discarded and the program edited. We'll be right back. This is Rich Jeffrey speaking for Super Password, a Mark Goodson television production.
Super Password! Our special guest this week, Ron Nightcourt, Lawrence Hallam, and Richard Moll. And the star of Super Password, Bert Crumbly.
Right there, my dear. There you are, Florence. All right, thank you. Thank you very much. I thank you so much, and welcome to Super Password, and nobody better get out of line today. Because you will quickly be under arrest. It's great to have you with us. We have taken a week off from our regular programming. Last week, as you know, was the Tournament of Losers. We are now going to pick up where we left off, and we had some players who were waiting patiently to come out. But this is, I think this is wonderful. You both look great. Welcome to you, Florence, your
Thank
first
you.
Time here.
Thank you.
It's nice to have you with us.
Thank you.
Especially in uniform.
Well, we thought it might be fun.
I think it is fun. I think it's just great. So is he treating you right on the show?
No,
by the way?
No.
Is he difficult to work with?
Yes, he is. He's very good.
Why,
I adore Richard.
Yeah, well, I said to you before the show, it's a tribute to both of you. You've been on for a season together, and you're still speaking, and you're friends, and you're here together. That's nice.
No, we're
it?
Not speaking.
Oh, I'm sorry. You'll be speaking to me, and I'll be speaking to her. Is
yes,
that
we
it?
Tell Florence to pick up her pace.
Well, now, you've never been on the Password before, but
nope,
you know
I've
how
watched
we,
it.
You know how mm-hmm. we do this.
Oh, yeah, I think.
Wait a minute.
What?
Florence is wearing the same thing I am.
Yeah. Oh, don't get
they
upset.
Told me this was an original.
No, don't get upset. It's just we just did it because we thought it'd be nice to have both of you in.
Oh, okay.
You won't be mad. Oh, when he gets mad, you know, he eats.
No, I just want to say it's really nice to be here on Double Jeopardy, and I'm really looking forward to it. Oh my God, I'm on the wrong stage.
Get back here. Sit yourself down. Okay, hold on to your hats, gang. If you're ready to go, Florence.
Okay.
Off we go. Let's meet our players who've been waiting patiently. Come on out, Janet and Wendy. Hi, Wendy. Nice to see you again. Hi, Janet.
Hi.
Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Okay, these two lovely ladies were here, as I said before, and we have a champion, Wendy, and Janet just got here. And so, Janet, tell us about yourself first, if you will, please.
All right. My name is Janet Henderson. I live in Chatsworth. I'm a student in my first year at Moore Park College, and I'm soon to be employed by a big, beautiful, brand-new hotel.
Is that right?
Yes.
And which you can't say the name of?
Well, I don't think I can.
No, you can't. And it's brand new? It hasn't...
Brand new, hasn't opened yet.
Can you tell us where it's going to be?
In Woodland Hills.
Oh, I think I know what it is. Mm-hmm. Yes, I know. Well, that's wonderful.
Thank
and,
you.
And welcome once again.
Thanks.
Wendy's our current champion. She has $1,600 so far. Welcome to you again, and thank you for waiting patiently that week through our Tournament of Losers.
Well, I had an exciting week.
You
My
did?
Name is Wendy Mascariello. I'm a newlywed of about 8 months.
Oh, you did have an exciting week.
Well, during the week, I was job interviewing and I got a job.
You did?
Yes.
Really? It's not at a new hotel, is it? Or?
No. No, not a new hotel. I'm going to be an assistant to an architectural director at a University of California.
Really? How wonderful. Well, that's good. Then we're bringing you luck, let's pretend.
Yes.
Okay. I hope you do have some luck today. We're off. Actually, where we are now is that Wendy has $300. As I said, Janet has zero, but that's because Wendy just won the $200 cash word, and there it is for you, the magic toaster to start the day
it's
off with.
Here.
I know. A terrible thing to do to you. The cash word is worth $3,000 today, which is very nice. You will have three chances to communicate that word. Take a look at it if you want to, Richard. We'll show the audience at home what the cash word is, and there it is, and we're ready for clue number one, sir.
Allure.
Entice.
Richard.
I can't believe it.
That was good, Richard.
I really understand that was a rotten clue, wasn't it? An allure, and you got. Well, there you are. What a nice way to start off. See how easy it's done? That's why he's tough. I can't believe that. Nice going. Well, you just added to your. You now have $4,600. Isn't that the right? With our score, $300 for Wendy. Janet, who has yet to score, but will. We will change partners, break away for a commercial, and come right back. Go away.
Weekdays starting at noon, Buzzer is the place to play with our most popular shows. That's why daytime is playtime.
Every day you must watch.
Weekdays starting at noon Eastern, only on Buzzer. Let's play.
You haven't opened your mouth yet, and Wendy's already won $3,000 today. It's your turn now, okay?
Okay, I'm
this
ready.
This is the time. This is a $300 puzzle, and if you're going to tie it up, this is how you're going to do it. By the way, we are playing for $15,000 over there, so a lot of money at stake. Okay. First word, please. Florence and Richard giving the clues, and you'll see it pop up in there, Florence, and there it is. Everybody at home has it. Richard, lead us off, if you will.
Female?
Male.
No, that's a good way to start. Perfect. On the board, we have male. Janet, what could that possibly be?
Oh, male. Could it be a man?
Could male. It be man? Why not? Very male. Good guess, by the way. I try to be fair to everyone. Here we go. No, I was thinking mailman. It could very well have been. It's not the thing that you would normally think of. Richard?
Cigarette.
Cigar.
Okay. Florence, please.
End.
But.
Yes. Perfect. Good for you. Watch out now.
Male
okay.
butt?
Male butt. Mercy. This is for the game, Wendy.
About the only thing I can think of is a stripper.
Okay, for the game, all your guesses are for the game. Is it a stripper? No, but it might have been. Here we go. No, next word, please. There it is, Florence.
My turn?
Yes, ma'am.
Material.
Fabric.
Okay, Richard.
Material.
Wool.
Yes. Great clue. That's a way to play the game. Nail, butt, and wool. Janet?
I have no idea.
I don't either. I should know. Gene, do you know what it is?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Just was checking to be sure you were still up to par here. Have you ever not known what it is?
Nope.
Okay. So the folks at home what this word is. Richard, if you will, please.
Antlers.
Horns?
Yep, that's it. Well, you're going great. You guys are so good. Does anybody miss anything? Okay, male, butt, wool, and horns. And you need this one, Janet.
Is it a sheep?
Is it a sheep? Here we go. Next word, please. And last one. Richard?
Sheep.
That's a very good clue. Very good clue. That was very well done. No, that was a very good clue. I swear to God, that was a very good clue. That was such a good clue that we're going to put it on the board, and we're going to let, we come over here and let Wendy have a guess at what our puzzle is. I think that's what we have to do for the game. We have male, butt, wool, horns, and sheep. Wendy?
I thought it was a goat.
What did you say?
Goat.
She said that before. Is it a goat? Okay, Florence.
Is it a ram?
Is it a, for the game, by the way, is it a ram? Yeah. That's the way we play that, right? Yep. Oh, gosh, what a shame. Well,
Female.
Did you know what it was, by the way, Janet?
I probably would have.
Did you know what it is, what it was, Richard?
Yeah, I didn't think the clue was that broad.
No, that was the word, sir. See, the word was sheep, and you said sheep.
Oh, did I?
Yeah.
Well, I was thinking of the answer to the puzzle. Yeah. Boy, am I dumb sometimes.
That's why the clue was
thinking
broad.
I beg your pardon. I was thinking of the answer. I was thinking ahead.
You were thinking
ram. I knew what it was, and I was thinking course, ram when I saw
and said the word. Oh, I'm sorry.
So well, I'm trying to get her to say ram.
Janet, I'm very sorry.
Too soon.
Janet, don't lose hope. You didn't win any money, but I must tell you, we have just come off our annual tournament of losers for people who did not win any money, and I have a feeling you'll be back for that. In fact, I promise you, you'll be back for that. I'm terribly sorry. Thanks for being here. I'm sorry. We're going to play for $15,000 right now, Florence.
Oh,
here we
God.
Go. Okay, ladies.
I can't
open your coat. Listen here, Florence.
All right.
Okay. Now, make sure. Can you see over Wendy's head okay there? You sure? All right. Now, Wendy, you know what to do. This is your second time here, right? Your first time,
Lord,
Florence.
Lord.
We're starting you off good, aren't we?
Yeah.
Okay, we're going to give you 10 words beginning with M and continuing through V, all right? M through V. Everyone you get right, I'll give you $100. If you get them all, I will give you $15,000.
Can't wait.
Okay? Okay. Now, Florence, this is really easy over here.
It is.
I think this is easier than over there sometimes.
You do?
Yes, I do. It's 60 seconds. I'm going to show you your first word, and you have plenty of time. 60 seconds takes a long time. Don't say anything yet. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, ready? Good luck and go.
Instrument.
Music.
Laboratory.
Microscope.
N.
Pester.
Gnat.
Pester.
Annoy. Nag.
O.
September.
October.
P.
Bird.
Pelican.
Tox.
Parrot.
Q.
Nickel.
Quarter.
R.
Cooking.
Rotisserie.
Directions.
Roast. Recipe.
S.
Circular.
Sound.
I can't say that.
T.
Bow.
Tie.
U.
Lower.
Upper.
V.
Blood.
Veins.
Yes. Now what happened there?
What did I do wrong?
Oh, did you do that? Oh, I couldn't see from behind. Apparently, they ruled it illegal because you went like this with your hand.
Oh.
I didn't see it from the back.
I don't think I did.
No?
I don't think I did.
You don't think you did?
No.
Police officers never lie, you know.
No.
Apparently, they said you did. I was in the back, or I'd fight for you. But you saw Florence do this? You tricky devil. I'm terribly sorry.
Well, I'm going to sit on my hands.
You got 9 out of 10. You're still here. You can come back again. You have a grand total of $5,800. Not so bad. The next time Super Password will be worth $5,000 more or $20,000. And we'll come back and see who plays for that in just a moment. Don't go away. Too bad. I didn't see you do that. Well, look how you forget. Because Richard said she didn't have it. We're back. We're talking. Florence says she doesn't remember doing it. You know, that's what happens. Of course, you didn't even realize you had said the word sheep.
No, I didn't. I was trying to go for the answer to the puzzle up there.
It happens all the time. In fact, it happened last week. I think it happened the week before. It's just one of those things. You're playing, you're concentrating so hard, and you do things you don't realize you do. But that one happens fairly common, looking in there and saying the word. Because after all, it is the best clue. There's no question about it. All right, Wendy, you can go back again. You've only been there twice. You can go back over there three more times. Here is a fellow who's going to try to keep you going over there, from going over there, and he's after the $20,000, too. Would you come in, Del, please?
Hi, Del.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you. Nice to meet you. Hi, Richard. Fine. How are you doing?
Well, sir, tell us about yourself. No, he's fine. Don't worry about him. He'll come back strong this time. No, it's okay. No, I hate to see a big fella cry. Pull yourself. Thank you.
Okay,
Del.
Hello, Bert. My name is Del Hinckley. I'm originally from Indianapolis, Indiana. I now live in Santa Monica, and I do freelance public relations, and I like to play golf, and I like to angle.
What do you like about fishing?
Oh, the excitement of having something live out there on the end of the line, and you're trying to ring it in. And
I had that experience last night.
Never mind. Went to a singles bar, did you? Okay.
That's angling.
That's angling.
That's an angle.
Well, welcome to you, and good luck, Del. And
nice
here we go, gang. This is a $100 puzzle, as I said, playing for $20,000 over there. Let's go to it. Florence, you and Richard will be giving the clues. Here comes the first word of the $100 puzzle. Off we go. Richard, please.
Yelling.
Screaming.
That's it. That's the way to start us off. On the board, we have screaming, Del.
Would it be a banshee?
Would it be a banshee? Maybe that was a banshee. I don't know what that was.
Whatever it is, it's under arrest. Yeah.
Jeff is at it again, you crazy. Here we go. Next word, please. There it is. Richard.
Cop.
Officer.
I'll kill you!
Florence.
Cop.
Policeman.
Right.
Richard?
Oh.
When you said policeman? I didn't hear what
you
said.
Yes, that's correct.
Officer?
Sir?
You said it now.
Can I say officers? Sorry.
No, you said officer. First time.
Patrolman.
I'd like the jury to disregard the S on that, please. Here's the fourth and final clue, Florence.
You're not allowed to point.
As long as you don't point and giggle, I guess it's okay.
Can we go up and come in again?
No, you can't point, darling. You can't do that.
I can't do that. No. I'll try it anyway. Uniform.
Police.
Right.
We'll put it on the board, but nobody guesses.
Police.
Nobody guesses. They're not going to let you guess because of the gesture. I can't believe it. We've never had trouble like this. We got two cops on the show. We can't do it right. Huh?
Nothing
but illegal clues all over the place. All right, nobody. We're not going to let you guess because of the gesture. Correct? Okay. Moving right along. Next word, please. Okay, Florence, you're up now. No pointing, gesturing. There you go.
Racing.
Speeding.
That'll do it. Perfect. Perfect. And you didn't have to do anything about it. Screaming police and speeding, Wendy.
Could it be a siren?
Is it a siren? You bet. Didn't need ambulance and didn't need alarm. Okay. We'll come back in just a moment with lots more illegal stuff after this message for you. Don't go away.
Up next, the Super Password Mini Marathon continues, and these stars are playing to win. Do you think they're hiding their thesaurus under their desk? I do. Stay tuned.
This is the $200 puzzle. The cash word is worth $1,000 because Wendy cleaned it out just a few moments ago. Our score, Wendy has $100. Del, you've got to score, but here's your chance now. Off we go. Wendy and Del giving the clues. Here comes your first word of the $200 puzzle, playing for $20,000. Del, please.
Restless.
Okay, we'll allow it.
Nervous.
All right, Wendy? Thank you, Wendy. Del, just barely making it.
Annoyed.
Bored.
All right. Fourth and final clue.
Restless.
Irritable.
No, the word is uncomfortable. We'll put it on the board and nobody guesses. Uncomfortable. Next word, please. There it is. Del?
Straight.
A little too much there, Wendy.
Straight.
Erect.
Del?
Hard.
I'm going to say posture.
Fourth and final clue.
Bored.
Got me.
Oh, that was great. Bored, what would you be? Stiff.
Stiff.
We'll put on the board, nobody guesses. Uncomfortable.
I was too.
But I want to tell you.
Uncomfortable.
There
stiff.
It is, Del. Yeah. What was bit through my lip?
Plastic.
Flexible.
Okay, Wendy.
Tree.
A plastic tree?
Good.
plastic tree?
Okay, Del. Carpentry. Okay, fourth and final clue.
Put these together.
Leg.
Stool.
No. How about if I... Oh, no, that wouldn't give it to you, though. Never mind. The word was wooden. We'll put it on the board. And nobody guesses. Uncomfortable, stiff, and wooden. Next word, please. Okay. Del.
Temple?
Forehead.
What did he say?
We can't get there from here. We were trying, but we're not getting there. He said temple, and he said forehead.
Temple?
Mm-hmm. Wendy?
Chapel.
Church.
Yes, that's the way to do it. Take a bow, take a bow. Uncomfortable, stiff, wooden, and church.
Do I guess?
Yes, ma'am.
Pew.
Is it pew? You bet. Didn't need bench. That's the way to do it. We'll be back in just a moment with our cash word after this message for you. See you guys. Say goodbye. Thanks for watching. See you tomorrow. Say bye.
A member of our studio audience will receive the amazing new Smith Corona typewriter with Spellright One electronic dictionary. It actually catches your mistakes before you do. Spellright, furnished by Smith Corona. And some of our departing contestants will receive a Sears catalog gift certificate, a spring catalog with over 1,200 pages of ideas, the most complete catalog in America. There's more for your life at Sears. It's the Missile three-way vac, broom vac, hand vac, tank vac, super powerful, extra versatile, no bags to buy. Missile three-way vac. Lee press-on nails, full nails with super stick tabs for long, perfect nails in seconds. Lee press-on nails. From out of the ocean comes a choice blended seafood, new delicacies now in the frozen food section. Whenever you get snack hungry, Little Debbie has a snack for you. Delicious, individually wrapped Little Debbie snack cakes, so economical, they're always priced to please.